The challenges faced by Muslims who've migrated to Australia to start new lives are, as we all know, formidable. Thank goodness then for Osmana Sami, one of those multi-talented human beings who, though he has experienced horror and humiliation in his life, sets out to bring his story to the rest of us with humour and affection. Sami was born in Iran in 1983 to Iraqi refugee parents. As he wrote in his 2015 autobiography, Good Muslim Boy, which won the New South Wales Premier's Literary Award, his father, Jafar al-Bakri, was tortured by Saddam Hussein's thugs and escaped to Iran, where he met his wife. And now comes Ali's Wedding, a delicious comedy scripted by Sami in collaboration with Andrew Knight and beautifully directed by Jeffrey Walker, his feature debut. Autobiographical in many respects, this reveals the multiple talents of its co-writer and leading actor, who effectively portrays himself, or a version of himself, on screen. In the film, Ali, Sami, came with his family to Australia via Iran after his brother was killed by a mine in Iraq. He lives with his family in the Melbourne suburbs and wants to be a doctor, but he does poorly in his exams. However, he boasts to his mates that he's done very well, and this information gets back to his father, Don Hani, who's the imam at the local mosque.
Ali, my good friend. University of Melbourne, here we come. 96.2, huh?
Maybe we should not be so vocal in our celebration. We must remember not all can bask under God's glory.
Tar'alawi. أنا أراهن عليه وهو قتل وقدود.
أنا ما أراهن.
If the Prophet had not banned gambling, I would bet my entire house that Ali would have a higher score than the way.
So, enlighten us, Ali.
Come on, Ali, tell us. This suspense is tingling.
Can you hear it?
There's no man alive smarter than his father.
Maybe only his son.
I got 96 also. 0.4.
I would have won a house!
Ali desperately wants to please his dad and to be a good Muslim, but it's not that easy. His parents believe in arranged marriages and have just the girl in mind for Ali, but he's fallen for Diane, Helena Sawaris, the daughter of a Lebanese fish and chip shop owner. Diane also wants to study medicine, and she did really well in her exams. Her father has, rather reluctantly, agreed to allow her to study alongside non-Muslims. Ali decides to go to medical school anyway and simply sneaks into classes to study, and for a long time he gets away with it. As the recent census showed us, Australia is changing, and films like Ali's Wedding surely contribute to the most positive aspects of those changes. The Muslim families depicted in the film are far from being dogmatic. They genuinely want to integrate into the fabric of Australian life. When Ali's brother, a mechanic, is criticised by his father for swearing, he points out that he's an Aussie now, and Aussies swear. Walker was fortunate to employ the services of one of this country's finest cinematographers, Donald McAlpine, whose work goes right back to my brilliant career and beyond, and who does his customary professional job here. The ensemble cast is excellent, the script is smart and often funny, and it all rings painfully true, as indeed it should. My only quibble is that, like the somewhat comparable American film The Big Sick, it's a bit long. It overstays its welcome by about 10 minutes. But that's a minor flaw when so much of the film is so engaging and, given the times we live in, so important. I'm giving it 4 stars.